If you're worried about the specter of the yield curve inverting, you may have good reason. The last 9 yield curve inversions in the US have been followed by an economic recession within, on average, 14 months. Economic recessions are usually reflected in falling stock prices. This data sample makes it look like the yield curve is a certain predictor of a coming recession and falling stock market prices. As usual, there is a lot more to the story. Bond yield is a term that describes the income that a bond pays relative to its price. The yield curve is a plot of yields for bonds of various maturities. On the left side of the chart, we have shorter maturities, and on the right side, we have longer maturities. On the y-axis, we have yields. The term premium is a well-documented risk factor that explains the differences in bond returns. Longer maturity bonds are riskier, and therefore they command higher expected returns. When you own a longer maturity bond, say 10 years, you own a future stream of income that will not change for 10 years. If interest rates rise, a 10-year bond with higher future cash flows can now be purchased. This reduces the relative value of your bond, causing the price to fall such that your yield matches the yield for a new bond with similar characteristics. The fall in price will be more severe for a 10-year bond than it will for a 2-year bond because the 10-year bond locks in a longer stream of cash flows. If you are locking your money up for a longer period of time, you are taking more risk. Due to the higher risk associated with longer maturity bonds, they typically command higher yields. Bringing this back to the yield curve, we would expect the plot to show that shorter maturities have lower yields and longer maturities have higher yields. This is what we would call a normal yield curve. The shorter end of the yield curve is determined by the rate that a government sets for overnight lending between banks. In the US, this is referred to as the federal funds rate, while in Canada, it is referred to as the policy interest rate. The longer end of the yield curve, on the other hand, is influenced by the market. If the policy rate starts rising, while longer maturity bonds are also rising in price, driving their yields down, we will see the yield curve begin to flatten, and eventually, it will invert. This is currently very close to happening in the US market, which is making investors nervous. A normal yield curve is often seen as a sign of a healthy economy. An inverted yield curve, on the other hand, is typically viewed as a signal of a coming economic recession. This does not mean that the yield curve is a useful market timing tool. Let's look at the 2008 financial crisis as an example. The US yield curve inverted in February 2006, which was followed by the S&P 500 posting a 14.52% return in US dollars over the following 12 months. The yield curve became upward sloping again in June 2007, which was well in advance of the market's major downturn from October 2007 through February 2009. If you had tried to time the market on the initial inversion, being out of stocks during the inverted period resulted in substantial missed gains. If you then bought back in when the slope of the yield curve became positive, you would have been buying in right before the crash. It is still true that yield curve inversions have preceded recessions and market downturns in the US, even if we couldn't have used that information to make investment decisions. But it is far too easy to look at only US data and conclude that the yield curve is a perfect predictor of a coming recession. Let's extend the data set. If we look at Australia, Germany, Japan, the UK, and the US, going back to 1985, there have been 14 instances of inverted yield curves. In 10 of those 14 cases, the inverted yield curve was followed by positive 3-year returns in the local stock market. The US may be 9 for 9 in yield curve inversions predicting bad stock markets, but the experience in other developed countries does not support the idea that an inverted yield curve should be relied on as a consistent indicator. Should you be worried about an impending market downturn? No more today than yesterday. Uncertainty is a constant. The shape of the yield curve does not change that. If you like hearing about the yield curve and what it means for you, we also discussed it on a bonus episode of the Rational Reminder podcast.